Dorothy here, drinking my prune juice martini. Recently, my sex drive has taken a menopause. I decided to meet up with Rose, Blanche, and Sophia at Katz's Deli for some pastrami on rye. Because, Lord knows, my dry old pastrami wasn't getting any action at home. Girls, let's tell our nastiest sex stories.
Check, please.
Blanche, you start.
Well, a few weeks ago, my good friend Alberta passed away. Now, I knew Alberta's husband was a real shaker in the sack. See, he had Parkinson's. We met that night. Oh, my body was tingling all over from the sight of his manhood. So I said, "Do you want a gummer?" Right in the middle of my no-denture adventure, his spirit released itself in more than one way.
He died?
Blanche, it goes to figure. The only way you could keep a guy stiff is with rigor mortis. Looking for that check?
Rose, what was your dirtiest sex story?
Two nights ago, I met up with an old boyfriend from St. Olaf who I hadn't seen in 50 years. Let's just say it was an affair to forget.
Sven, remember when we did it once in the ice shed by the lake and we got stuck to the ice?
I love that movie. Are you my daughter?
Sven had Alzheimer's. Say my name.
Margaret.
No, that's not it.
Judy.
No.
Roger.
Good enough.
Okay, now it's my turn.
Come on. We all know as well as you do that the closest you're ever gonna get to a man is by looking in the mirror.
Mom, you're being testy.
You have testes.
Fine, Mom. Why don't you tell a story?
My nastiest sex story would have to be when I was a cheerleader for the high school basketball team.
Sophia, I never knew you were a cheerleader in high school.
I wasn't. This was last week. Go team! It was wonderful. They ran a train on me.
Oh boy!
I had more balls in my face than a circus seal.
I'm just gonna leave some money on the table.
The girls like it wild, but I prefer a quiet night at home playing Jeopardy with my hand on the buzzer.
Juggling knives. Maybe you don't have a future, but I'm gonna direct movies.
Or lose all your hair.
Or lose all my... Hey! Oh, God! Ralph!
Never fear, the Fonz is here.
But he's dead, Fonz.
But I can turn women on, I can turn the jukebox on, I can turn things on. Looks like I was I f***ed up.
I'll calm them down with my gorgeous singing voice. Who's my baby?
Fonzie, you have to do something.
I turn things on. I never tried turning them off.
We're gonna die, Fonz.
Oh, you're shark bait.
Fonz, you're gonna have to turn me off.
But I
turn me off, Fonzie.
I love you.
I'm sorry my power screwed your life up again, Master. I'll see you tomorrow.
What are you doing? It looks like you have brain freeze.
I'm doing Kegels.
Is that like a mix between a croissant and a bagel?
Uh-oh. I think I just broke my vagina.
We interrupt this program with breaking news. A powerful 9.2 earthquake has struck off the coast of Europe. Now back to two broke girls, already in progress.
So you're not going to bandage her labia? Where'd you even go to school?
No. It will heal if she just leave it alone for a few days.
That's like asking a fish not to swim.
An update on the European quake. A wall of water 90 feet high is expected to reach land within the hour. Now, two broke girls.
Oh, your soup's cold, lady? Well, guess what? I just broke my...
Oh my gosh, whose cat is that?
Ladies and gentlemen, Europe is now underwater. Millions of lives are presumed lost. Please, pray for everyone affected by this tragedy. And now back to two broke girls.
Penis!
Thank you.
Chained up next to Slater? This really is a torture chamber.
Hey, where's Screech?
It's all in due time, children.
You jerkwad!
What have you done with our friend?
If you really want to know...
Look at me! I'm Jesus!
In that case, God should demand a paternity test.
Silence! In the center of the room is a red button. Press it, and Samuel Screech powers will be torn to pieces.
Now, why the heck would we do that?
Press the button, and I let the rest of you go free.
That's an impossible choice. You're sick.
Sorry. It's kind of my only hobby.
Wow, that is devious. Kind of wish I thought of that.
The game begins now!
If we push the button, we all go free.
Slater, don't even think about it.
Just press the button. You're my best buds. Save yourselves.
Oh, Screech.
Forget it, Screech. All for one and one for all.
Children, I forgot to mention something. If you press the button, you also get free Corvettes.
Why isn't he dead yet?
No!
Clark, damn it!
Hang on, hang on! Stop hitting the button so hard! You're breaking it!
Make it work!
I hate you guys! I can't believe I masturbated to Callie and wanted to bang Lisa! You suck!
Yo, fuck the button! Just give me a blunt object! I'll beat him to death!
Stop! Stop! Just stop! Stop! Hey! Wait a minute!
It's me! Principal Belding! You're not really prisoners. This was just a trust exercise to help students learn to depend upon each other.
Stop! Stop! Stop!
Just slit his throat!
Use my nail file!
For the love of God!
Yes, Slater?
So we really don't get Corvettes?
No. Are there any other questions?
Me.
Are there any questions not pertaining to Corvettes?
Oh, man.
I fucking hate you guys.
Say that again.
That's the way they all became the Brady Bunch.
All lies. The perfect family was really the perfect cover.
This tastes different today.
Alice added pee.
Ah, peas.
I'm the housewife with a maid. Took you this long to figure out what I was doing all day?
Like I cared about you and the rent-a-kids anyway. Here's a better story of a buddy lady who's dead, who's fucking dead.
Is that the door? I'm waiting for Davy Jones to answer my letter. Ow! My nose!
Marsha! How come she gets blown up and I don't?
Mommy, Kitty Carryoff says lips are cute and recommends corrective surgery.
No, we wouldn't go to hell because she's not really our sister.
So, these feelings are natural?
No! Damn you, Tiki Idol!
Hey, ask us the sex question.
Now that the kids are gone, the sex has never been better.
I agree.
You're a big hand now, Thing. I think it's time you went and made it on your own.
I'm sorry, Thing, old man.
I gotta hand it to you, Mr. Thing. Your resume is very impressive. Massage therapy, palm reading, ensemble, and Annie. Well, I'm willing to give you a shot, kid.
Hey, Thing. Let me introduce Allison from accounting. She needs a ride home tonight, if you can handle it.
Oh, Thing.
It's not you, Thing. It's me. I want to have children someday, and you don't have reproductive organs. I'm sorry.
Thing. Sorry things didn't work out with Allison. No pun intended. But I'd like to introduce you to the new girl from accounting, Thing Amajig.
Thing Amajig, I now pronounce you hand in hand.
How are they going to, you know, do it?
Just funky with your fingers. Funky with your fingers.
Hey, Al, what you doing?
Brian, I'm just listening to some old tunes I wrote back on Melmac.
You were a musician?
Yeah, I even have an old music video I shot. Check it out. Coming straight out of Melmac. That's where I'm at. What's my favorite dish? You know it's cat. Eat so many cats, my belly's flabby. But Alf ain't eating no regular tabby. Got expensive taste, I get my pick of the litter. Chomping deep fried Siberian kitten fritters. You eat skinny cats, I like my felines fat. I eat fat bald cats that look like fat ass rats. Cat burgers, cat dogs, man, you think I'm a liar? Bitch, I once ate a Sumatran tiger. I eat cat tail churros and declawed paws. I sip kitty soup out of an Egyptian vase. While you're all eating alley cats covered in fleas. Your boy Al's eating cats that are Siamese. I eat Burmese biscuits for breakfast. A short-haired stack for brunch. In between a Manx or a lynx to munch. Take down a Persian virgin sphinx for lunch. For dinner I chow on Arabian Mao. Even got a snow leopard in my tummy right now. So what you know about that? I eat gourmet cat.
I've eaten so much pussy. I've eaten so much pussy. I've eaten so much pussy.
Maybe that's a good point to stop.
Wow, that was awesome. I want to be just like you.
That's great. You want to rap?
No, I'm going to eat our cat. Come here, Lucky.
Ha! I like your style, kid. Save me some butthole. It's the best part.
Don't worry, Ross. One day, you'll find your lobster.
What? Everyone knows lobster's made for life.
You're wrong about the lobsters. First, lobsters sense each other with their antenna, kind of like when you check a girl out at a bar. Then the female pees on the male, also what I do at a bar. I'm just serious. Then they throw a few jabs at each other, and then if she's impressed, they move in together, where she knights him. Then she takes off her shell. It's called molting, but Aunt Heather calls it, Lauren, stop being a whore. Anyway, they boink for about a week nonstop. Then they even eat their molted shell, weirdos. Then she leaves impregnated, never looking back. That's how lobsters have sex. How do I know? Because I am one! Anyone want a hand job?
Yep, other networks may have Shark Week, but that's expensive and scary and way too sharky for a webcam show. So this week on iCarly, it's Duck Week.
Carly, you're gonna be late for school.
Oh, crap. Look at the time. We'll be back later with more iCarly Duck Week. Bye. Okay, and off. Oh, man, I wonder what the world record for a shower is. Oh, God, it's cold! Oh, wow, I didn't know the iCarly eye nipples got that hard. Oh, those are some glass cutters.
Carly, move it!
Here's the Duck Week promo. Hey, where's Freddy?
He said I could do it this time.
Oh, Gibby, you're so sweet. You're like a water balloon filled with high fructose corn syrup.
I'm gonna get juvenile diabetes. Gibby! Time to do some uploading. Better get comfortable.
Oh, God, it's cold. Oh, wow. I didn't know the iCarly eye nipples got that hard.
Colonel Shay, isn't it time for your daughter's webcast?
Why, so it is. Thank you, Ensign.
I love Carly's
it's
show.
So funny.
It's the best part of the week.
Oh, wow. I didn't know the iCarly eye nipples got that hard. Wow, those are some glass cutters.
I failed as a father and as a man. I'm resigning my commission.
You can't, sir. They'll court-martial you.
Then I might as well do something worth court-martialing. Set a course for the Arabian Sea. Let's do what President Obama never had the balls to do.
Yeah! Let's do it!
Would have voted for Ron Paul, guys.
Shut up, Larry!
Wow, those are some glass cutters.
My life is over!
You see the news? Carly, I think Dad just nuked Iran!
What?
Al-Qaeda strike teams will hunt us for the rest of our lives! We gotta go off the grid! Ow! Stop poking me with your nipples!